On a beautiful day in Southern California, the storied Rose Bowl in Pasadena is the setting for USC and UCLA. Pete Carroll and the Trojans are a win away from playing for a national championship. But Carl Durrell and the Bruins aren't impressed by BCS numbers. They're looking to send Michigan or Florida to Arizona to meet Ohio State. They are all watching, waiting, and wondering. Where will we go? Who will we play? And for what prize? When the Trojans and Bruins collide today, dominoes will fall, ripples will be felt in every corner of the college football world. With a win, Pete Carroll's team earns his third straight trip to the national title game. But in their way, a crosstown rival longing to become a big-time spoiler. The outcome will influence fortunes far and wide. One game to be played, so many fates to be decided. When USC meets UCLA, next. You are looking live at the San Gabriel Mountains and the view down to the Rose Bowl where a sellout crowd is ready. We should have a dandy. USC and UCLA. Welcome, everybody. With the coach, Bob Davey, I'm Brett Musburger. You know the main storyline. Trojans come in favored by a couple of touchdowns, need a win to get down to the championship game. So, let me ask you about UCLA. What must they do to stay in it and perhaps forge an upset here?
Brent, I think UCLA has a shot. They play good defense. They have a great place kicker. It's always easier to be the underdog, play the role of spoiler, because there's no pressure. And the greatest motivation for UCLA, fear of embarrassment. The Trojans beat them 66-19 last year. They've had to live with that all year in this crosstown rivalry.
This has been a fabulous run by the Trojans. Any chance for a letdown here?
Well, conventional wisdom tells you USC set up for a letdown, but USC and the conventional football team, and Pete Carroll isn't a conventional football coach. The last 4 years, Brent, they've taken everybody's best shot. They've handled everybody's challenge. Too much at stake. Pete Carroll had this football team focused today.
So pull up your favorite chair. Sit back and enjoy. It's from the Rose Bowl. It's USC and UCLA. Presented by Dish Network. UCLA coach Carl Durrell with a quarterback decision this week. And for more on that, let's go to our colleague, Lisa Salters. Lisa.
Well, Brent, Carl Durrell sat both of his quarterbacks down on Wednesday before practice and told them that Patrick Cowan would indeed be the starter this week. Now, Durrell at yesterday's walkthrough told me, he said, we just felt it was best for us to keep going with the guy we've been working with for the last 6 weeks to keep the status quo. I talked to Cowan in Westwood on Thursday after their practice, and he said he had been preparing all week as if he was going to be the starter, even though he didn't know for sure. I asked him about maybe putting added pressure on himself, knowing that Ben Olsen is now healthy and waiting in the wings, and he admitted, it's hard not to have that in the back of my mind, but I cannot let myself get sidetracked. He said, I know what I have to do. Our entire team knows what it has to do. We've been emphasizing our team motto all week, and that is, we do not have to be the best team in the country. We just have to be the best team on the field today. Brent.
All right, Lisa, thank you on a beautiful day here in Pasadena. So Carl Durrell and quarterback Patrick Cowan will handle the ball first. USC won the flip, and they have deferred. So the Bruins will take the football, and Carl looking for his first win against Pete Carroll and the Trojans. 5-0 against arch rival UCLA since he became the head coach. Just one of the remarkable numbers that Carroll has forged at USC. Troy Van Blarkum, who's had some difficulty reaching the end zone with his kickoffs lately from the 35. He said no injury problems. He's a head case. So there's a kicker who admits it and right away finds the end zone. They'll take a knee, and Cowan and the Bruins will bring it out. So let's talk about Patrick Cowan and the UCLA offense. Coach, what do we expect to see here?
I think the first thing, the reason Patrick Cowan got the nod, Brent, over Ben Olsen, he can run. He can get away from the pressure that you know USC is going to bring. I look for UCLA to line up and try to run the football, though, against this USC defense.
He's 6'5", 218, and on first down, they go empty. marquee is not lined up in the traditional spot. The leading receiver, USC, with enormous pressure. Second down and 10. And terrific coverage by Brian Cushing, who dropped off the defensive line. So there is Marquis, and he'll be busy today. Brandon Brazil, UCLA needs a big play wide receiver. Will it be him? Should Cowan struggle, there's the left-hander, Ben Olsen. Started the first five games, went out then with a knee injury, but he is healthy and ready to go here today. Now Marquis is ready on second and 10, lined up behind Cowan. That's Petrie, the fullback, who will lead Marquis. And this is going to be third and long right away. Our outback offensive lineup for quarterback Patrick Cowan and the gentleman he has in front of him. And he will count on Alexi Lanis, been slowed by the flu this week. And Shannon Tabaka right there on the left side of the line. So they have to hold up against this USC defense here today. And right away the Trojans put the Bruins in third and long. Has time, fires middle, incomplete. He threw high that time. So it's three and out, and Cowan had a receiver open, Coach.
Brent, he did excellent job of pass protection by UCLA as Pete Carroll brought the safety blitz, and Baumgartner was open across the middle. But if one thing Patrick Cowan struggles with, Brent, it's consistency with accuracy throwing that football.
Aaron Perez back to punt. Reed, the deep man for the Trojans. Desmond hit right away and down at the 33-yard line. And that's where we will see John David Booty and the Trojans for the first time here this afternoon. Matthew Slater, terrific coverage that time. Just nailed Reed as soon as he caught the football. Here's John David, 25 touchdowns and 8 interceptions, doing a solid job replacing Matt Lyon.
And impressed me so much last week, Brent. He had the 2 interceptions late in the first half against Notre Dame, but bounced back in the second half and had a phenomenal second half.
The freshman, C.J. Gable, the starter. Chauncey Washington still a little nicked up. We will see him. Split backs throwing, almost intercepted. Incomplete, second down and 10. Christian Taylor, whose ankle completely healed, was the man there in the middle on that play. He's your middle linebacker for the Bruins.
One thing you'll notice early, this UCLA defense undersized, but they can really run. Reggie Carter, 218-pound freshman linebacker right there.
Second down and 10. The zone blocking, looking for Gable on the stretch on a cutback just short of the 40-yard line. Chris Horton, the safety, up to make the stop. Jack Follard, our Pac-10 referee today. The umpire is Timothy Morris there. Time for our IBM Star Watch. There's CJ, the freshman. We told you about him. Dwayne Jarrett, coming off a big game. He's been on a run. And Fred Davis, the tight end, figures very prominently in Pete Carroll's plans here today. Meanwhile, the Trojans will have to deal with a second down on the other side of the 30-yard line. Ball is spotted right about the 29-yard line after the holding call.
This UCLA defense, fourth in the country in sacks with 37, the two defensive ends with 24 sacks combined.
Gable back in as the running back on second and 19 for USC. Booty drops it off. Here's Davis's first catch of the game. We told you he finished very prominently in the final plans for this game.
USC's only given up 7 sacks in the last 7 games, and this is a big part of it. You see Booty step up and a little check down right there to Fred Davis. That's a great scheme of offense, Brent, where you don't let that quarterback take a sack.
That is a setback for Dwayne Walker's defense to let him out on second and a bunch, and they come up with a first down pass of 20 yards to Davis. Remember, it was second and 19 when they came out. Now the freshman running back crosses midfield. And the stop by Christian Taylor at our outback offense. We've talked about John David Booty and C.J. Gable. And there are the two tackles we mentioned. Sam Baker on the left side and Kyle Williams over on the right. They have to hold up against Justin Hickman and Bruce Davis. Here's Coach mentioned. Look down on a grand, grand scene. Second down and three, the Rose Bowl. Wide open on the left side. They just blew behind Baker and Radovich for a first down. Now the Bruin defense. And you can see immediately they are under fire by this USC offense. And there, Davis and Hickman, the two defensive linemen, and Trey Brown. Now, he's the best of their corners, but he's only 5'9". And he has to stand up against 6'5". 6'5", and six even wideouts. And Jarrett goes over to the right side now on first down from the 40. Trey Brown gets ready. Gable. And he is brought down by Dennis Keyes, the free safety.
I talked to Pete Carroll on the field before the game, and I asked him, this is an undersized UCLA defense. They love to run those defensive ends up the field. I said, will you be patient and run the ball? He looked at me and smiled and said, no, we're going to do what we do and throw the football. But right here, they are running the football, Brent, taking advantage of the size advantage they have.
And they've got the four wideouts in there right now on this play, Coach. Second down and seven. There's that quick throw outside. They put it in the hands of Chris McFoy. And again, it's Dennis Keyes, the busy safety, making the stop.
And that play, you see it so much in college football, just the little look pass if the defense doesn't cover down and move out in space. It's really like a running play. Just get the ball in Chris McFoy's hands, let him make a play.
Fred Davis and Dale Thompson, both tight ends in for USC. Gable's a running back. Here's your third down and one. Bruins press the defensive front, and Booty looking to throw out of it, and incomplete. And it did not fool Bruce Davis. The defensive end blew that play up that time.
And Bruce Davis from Houston, Texas. His dad played offensive line here at UCLA. You're going to see him at the top of the field. They leave the tight end, number 89, Dale Thompson in. Another good job by Booty of stepping up, but just too much pressure.
Trojans will go for it on fourth down. The junior, Chauncey Washington, checks in as the I-back. A fullback lined up in front of him. Need a yard. Here comes Washington for it. Will not get it. The Bruins jump him and take over on downs.
That is a huge stop, and they're going to bring the corner, Rodney Van, off the tight end side. They get penetration in the backfield, and that is big stop right there for the Bruins.
Not a good memory in the Rose Bowl on fourth down for Pete Carroll. We'll tell you that story when we come back. It's USC and UCLA. Yeah, nothing fuels the population of Southern California quite like the Rose Bowl on New Year's Day. And slipping the tackle, Marquis. Here, no score yet. 6 minutes left in the opening quarter. UCLA's first two drives were three and out, but not this time. There's their first down of the game out to the 31-yard line, and Cowan on the move hit the running back, Chris Marquis, the junior from Louisiana.
Great play action fake right here, and Marquis coming out of the backfield. And Brent, you can see why Pat Cowan got the start. This mobility right there, being able to throw on the run.
17-yard gain, Coach. He's now one of four, his first completion. His best pass of the game was called back because of a penalty, so it is first down and 10. And that'll settle the nerves a little bit. Those last two balls have been very well thrown by Cowan. He comes back, and Marquis, nothing doing. Just jammed right at the point of attack by this stout front.
Chris Markey, you mentioned out of Louisiana. He was Mr. Football in the state of Louisiana. Is not only their leading rusher coming into this game with over 900 yards. We see him limping a little bit. Also, Brent, their leading receiver with 33 catches. So this guy is the whole package when it comes to running and catching the football.
Being tended to on the sideline, and Derek Williams, the junior, number 30, is in as the tailback for the Bruins. Motioning out of the backfield here on second down and 10. Slipped, takes off. There's that running ability. He's got a first down and more. Running across midfield. Brilliant run by Cowan and Lawrence Jackson, the defensive end in pursuit. That is a 30-yard gain. Last week, Brady Quinn of the Irish reeled off a 60-yard run, and here it's a 30 for Patrick Cowan.
Brent, I think that was a bust right there by the USC defense. You saw that huge hole open up, but what a lick and what a hustle play by Lawrence Jackson right there. That's the defensive lineman coming downfield, but I think USC busted. They weren't in their rush lanes on that play.
Ball is spotted at the Trojans 41-yard line. First drive of the afternoon for the Bruins. Derek Williams stays in as the running back. Receivers are bunched to the right. Petrie is the fullback. Play fake again, buys time. Didn't gain much, though. Perhaps picked up a yard, and let us check in with Lisa Salters.
Well,
Lisa?
Brent, you noticed Cowan slipping on that play before last. This is a brand new field here at the Rose Bowl. The first time anybody has played on it before. It was put in, let's say, after on the November 11th game that the Bruins had against Oregon State. A half hour after that game ended, they started ripping up the old field and started putting in the new one. It's called a Bullseye Bermuda and Rye Grass Blend. Costs about $100,000, and the folks here at the Rose Bowl say that this is like a stage, and they want the athletes here to have the best. Brent?
Second down and 8. Markey back on the field. Second effort, first down, and UCLA driving here in the opening quarter.
Markey gets an excellent block right here by his fullback Petrie right there on Keith Rivers, and you see how physical Markey is. And right now, Brent, UCLA taking it to USC.
Already 3 first downs on this drive. Derek Williams checks back in as the running back. They set that power eye formation, and then they let Cowan go. Middle is open, and he scampers all the way to the 11-yard line. He just dropped back, and the Red Sea parted, and it's 16 more yards running, and the Trojan defense is going to have to adjust here.
And you can see why he got the start. You see Rivers, the linebacker, on the blitz, Brent, and he just takes it, and he is the guy you don't account for, the quarterback running the football. And right now, that's the biggest story of this game, is Patrick Cowan taking off and running with the ball.
See if the Trojans start to spy on him with a linebacker. They put 3 linemen down right now. Stan Cushy, Markey is your running back. There's that play fake again by Cowan, rolling left, looking, run, pass, going to keep it again. Crosses the 5-yard line and steps out of bounds. He's having a field day running the football on this drive.
And you talked about his dad was a quarterback at Washington, then played in the Canadian Football League. Not highly recruited. He was recruited by Idaho, Sacramento State. And Ben Olsen, the guy who's playing behind him today, was recruited by every school in the country.
Is Markey back? And he is stopped. That was Ellis. Cedric Ellis, number 49, rose up and made a big play. Third and goal. Carroll and the Trojans would love to hold them to a field goal, and they've got the best field goal man in the Pac-10.
And if I'm Carl Durrell, forget about that field goal. This is 2 down territory right now. You're a huge underdog in this game.
You wouldn't go on the board first if they fail here?
Not
all right. Might be moot if they can score here on third down. They're going to roll. Cowan, he's going to cut for the end zone. Dive. Bounce toward a touchdown, UCLA. Let's take a good look at the knee and the ball now.
Boy.
Close, but he might have had it, folks. So Coach Durrell looking good in his decision to leave Cowan under center and have Ben Olsen alongside him on the bench. Now here is Justin Medlock, one of the finest kickers in the country. And Cowan puts it down for the left foot kicker. Good hold. It is 7-0. Yobo, the underdog, strikes in Pasadena. That's what we like to see. 1:35 left in the opening quarter. UCLA strikes first. They lead the Trojans 7-0. Patrick Cowan, the sophomore quarterback, takes them right down the field.
And in a game like this, you are judged on this game and this game only. It's so big, not the body of work. And what a great opportunity for UCLA, Carl Durrell, and that young quarterback.
It almost looks like the Trojans are expecting an onside kick here. They have forced 9 men near the front. Just in case, Durrell and the Bruin coaching staff are going to empty the bag of tricks here. Now they back off too as they see the alignment. Justin Medlock. Into the end zone. Coming out to the 20. First down and 10 from the 44-yard line for John David Booty. Play fake. Didn't fool anybody, so he drops it off. Fumble! Caught by Jarrett. So Dale Thompson was the receiver. It was jarred loose up in the air, and right there was Dwayne Jarrett, the junior from New Brunswick, New Jersey. ESPN's College Football on ABC returns after this message and a word from our ABC stations. Back in the Rose Bowl with UCLA striking first. But the Trojans have crossed midfield, and they have a second down to start the second quarter from the 49-yard line. Jarrett, down at the bottom of your screen. Here's Gable. Gable trying to get the first down, and the stout Bruin front wouldn't let him. Let's take a look now, Coach, at our Pacific Life game summary.
I'm going to go right to the rushing yards right here with UCLA and Patrick Cowan, the quarterback, gaining the bulk of that yardage right there.
USC hurt themselves with 4 first quarter penalties also. This is your third down and 1, so let's see if Carroll and Lane Kiffin, who's upstairs, decide here just to keep it. Chauncey Washington, keep it on the ground. Williams, the lead fullback. Here it comes again. They are not getting short yardage. They've been stopped on a fourth down. Now they're thrown back by Reggie Carter on a third down. And the USC front is not dominating the front 7 of the Bruins.
And very seldom you see Pete Carroll not go for it on fourth down. But I understand completely why he just wants to punt this football right here. Good decision.
Fresh respect here. Wojnak, high punt. Fair catch signaled. And is stopped inside the 1-yard line. So that punt by Greg Wojnak pins UCLA back in the shadow of their own goal line. It's a 46-yard beauty.
Brent, keep in mind, in college football, it doesn't matter where your feet are. It doesn't matter where your body is. All that matters is where is the football. That football never crossed the plane of the goal line. It doesn't matter that USC's players are in the end zone. Great play right there by Sartz.
So the Bruins' first possession since they scored the touchdown, being led by running quarterback Patrick Cowan. 4 carries, 55 yards, and a touchdown. He's 2 of 5 throwing for 19 yards. Marquis has rushed for another 17. They're on the power eye. Marquis Bucks. They think they've got him in the end zone. You can see the Trojans. And he just, if he did, he just did slip out.
That's why a lot of times you see people throw the football. Again, the corner, Kerry Harris, right up on the line of scrimmage.
Marquis does an excellent job with the football as he's going down. He was able to adjust the football in his grip. Harris bringing him down. That was close, real close. Second down and 10.
And they are right in front of that USC cheering section. It is really loud down there.
Now USC presses the front. Cowan from the end zone. I believe there's a penalty flag thrown by the referee that's going to be holding. Half the distance to the goal is about an inch in penalty, if that's what it is. And Robert Chai, the center, with his hands full. I don't believe it was back in the end zone. Is back in the end zone? The Trojans are saying if holding's back in the end zone, it's a safety.
It is, Brent.
Holding, number 54 on the offense. In the end zone.
That's it, safety.
Safety.
No question.
You leave the center one-on-one with a player with the quickness of Cedric Ellis, the nose guard. That is a difficult matchup. We're going to see it right in your screen, right there, Brent.
Good call, bad call, Coach.
On the other angle I saw, Brent, I thought it was a good call. We'll take a look at it right here. Cedric Ellis one-on-one right there. Close, close, but it looked to me like it was a good call.
Now remember, the key to that was Wojnak's 46-yard beauty with a little backspin, and it was downed at the 1 yard line, and the Trojans are on the board with the safety, 7-2, and they'll get the ball back, and we send you down to Lisa.
Well, Brent, before that last series, USC linebackers coach Ken Norton Jr. lit into his linebackers saying, "You guys act like you've never seen a quarterback scramble before. That is the last scrambling yardage that Patrick Cowan gets." They did a good job on that last series. But remember, Brent, Ken Norton Jr., a lot of motivation for this game. He was a great UCLA Bruin linebacker back in the mid-80s. He came calling for a job back in 2004. Things didn't go his way. He ends up on the Trojan sideline, Brent.
Yeah, he was a great Bruin linebacker. He played for Terry Donahue. He beat USC in a classic back in 86, and Coach Carl Durrell caught a touchdown pass for Donahue in that game. So from the 10-yard line, here's Gable, the running back. Fultz, the world would-be tackler, and he is down. First down and 10. John David Booty at the controls. Three wide, bit of a changeup. Coming back with Gable, freshman running back. The first four drives, you can see how Trojans have struggled. 36, 16, 33, 7. Three punts and lost it on a fourth down.
And really, just constant pressure on John David Booty. Brent, I can't think of a time that he's actually been able to set his feet in the pocket and throw the football.
Here's second down. Linebackers creeping up, trying to get at John David. Smith is well short. Here's that third down. USC is 0-4 on third down, and they missed on a fourth down. So here comes their fifth third down of the afternoon.
And Brent, UCLA number one in the nation in third down defense, only giving up 26% of the time. Notre Dame was 4 of 19 on third down against UCLA. So this is just how the Bruins won, third down.
With the backfield empty, caught for a first down. Snapped it off and close to midfield, Dwayne Jarrett.
And that's the matchup they want. Rodney Vann on Dwayne Jarrett. But again, just a simple little slant route. He uses that big body, kind of that basketball influence as a young guy, Brent. Great positioning right there.
Now Jarrett will come out to the right. And Trey Brown will be the corner. They bring Smith in motion. They've got both the talent ones off to the right. John David Booty's going to look down and then drop it off. He looked long first, came to Gable. A beautiful check down by John David Booty and a first down.
And Brent, you just said it. What a great check down. The patience by John David Booty. We saw him hit Fred Davis, the tight end, earlier on the check down. Now he just flips it to C.J. Gable. Great offensive scheme in it. They always have an outlet for the quarterback.
Absolutely. And Chauncey Washington will replace Gable as the Trojan running back. Now Chris McFoy also on the field as a wideout. Booty looking for a receiver on the run. Throw complete to the 26-yard line. Smith, the receiver.
Good job by Booty. Avoided Bruce Davis, but he throws on the run right now. And Steve Smith, you know, Brent, he gets overshadowed a little bit by Dwayne Jarrett. But week after week, Steve Smith always comes up with clutch catches.
Jarrett back on the field. Patrick Turner, the third wideout. Thomas Williams, the fullback, set in a power eye, second and short. They run for the first down with Washington. And let's take you back to the Notre Dame game last Saturday night and Dwayne Jarrett's big night. He did it just about every which way. Shielded off the safety for a touchdown, went airborne up over a corner. One-handed spectacular grab, and then the human pinball wizard. Just shedding Irish defenders and racing to the end zone. And here's his Uncle Dave. He taught him how to catch with one hand when he was a little boy. Uncle Dave Jarrett in New Jersey would make him catch with one hand. He would practice that way, and the Bruins will use a timeout here.
Well, number one.
This guy right here, number eight, Brent, made himself some money last week on prime time against Notre Dame.
Better believe that, huh? A lot of folks think he'll be gone. He'll be a first-round draft choice if he goes. Well, it's time for the Aflac trivia question. Who is the only player to win three straight Super Bowls? Nobody should miss that one. First down and 10. Nobody should miss it. Inexcusable if you miss it first. Here's John David Booty. And on the move again, hitting Davis, the tight end. But again, that UCLA front, putting John David on the run with that defensive speed, the one thing that the Bruins have here, obviously, up front.
You are right. Bruce Davis that time, number 44, chasing from the backside. I mean, this defense can really, really run.
Second and six. Jarrett's off to the left. McFoy inside of him. Chauncey Washington, your running back. Washington, big hole middle, but short of the first down. Christian Taylor, the linebacker.
That was a great tackle by Christian Taylor. Transferred from the Air Force Academy. Finally healthy. He's had a nagging ankle injury all year. That is a great one-on-one tackle because there was a seam right there for Chauncey Washington. Not many guys transfer out of those academies.
Last year, Ohio State had a good one. Schlegel was their middle linebacker. And he played very well for the Buckeye team that beat Notre Dame in the Fiesta Bowl. Gable back as the running back. On the toss play, Gable, first down to the 6-yard line. It'll be first down and goal. USC in their last 8 trips to the red zone, they've scored every time. 5 touchdowns, 3 field goals, and they're moving again.
Last week against Notre Dame, USC ran a variation of this little flip play to the tailback. Again, they pick up the first down.
Dale Thompson checks in. That's how lethal they were in the red zone inside the 20-yard line last week against Notre Dame. Washington back in now. And Mike Brittingham is the fullback. Slipping is John David Booty. He'll have to throw it away out of the pocket, outside of the tackle area, and Bruce Davis again in pursuit.
Great coverage, Brent, by Trey Brown. They wanted to go to Jarrett right here. He plays off coverage. Trey Brown is their best corner. Good job of not looking back to the quarterback right there in man-to-man coverage, just focusing on Dwayne Jarrett.
Jarvis Brown's son, Trey Brown, a junior, Overland Park, Kansas. Second down and goal. Gable, the running back. Jarrett's off to the left. Gable stopped at the 2-yard line by the middle, and Dennis Keyes, the hard-hitting safety, enough to help out. It'll be third down and goal.
Keep in mind, USC last year, 679 yards and 66 points. Grinding for every point they can get right now in this game.
This year, though, they're averaging 32 points a game, USC is, being held to 2, and we're down to 1 minute left of the first half. Third down and goal on the toss. Gable dives, end zone, touchdown. USC leads for the first time today. Shades of Reggie Bush going airborne in the Rose Bowl.
And C.J. Gable started out the season as a true freshman starter, fell to third team, goes airborne for the touchdown.
Mario Dinello. Dinello is 41 of 43 on extra points, so he has missed a couple. But not this time.
And UCLA, Brent, has to be excited going in at halftime, only down by 2.
Well, Durrell on the other side is more of a stoic personality. He doesn't show his emotions publicly. But I'm sure he's going to be pleased at the way the Bruins have played here. Let's go down to Lisa.
Well, Brett, Coach, after being stopped the first 4 possessions of the game, what was different on that last touchdown drive?
No, we just hooked some stuff up. They're doing a nice job. They've had a couple weeks to prepare, and they threw a couple things at us. But I think we're settling down now. It's going to be a real nice second half now. These guys are fired up. They're in the game, and that's what they wanted at halftime. So we got to come out and play real good football second half and get a win.
Now, you were saying all week long that you knew that they were going to play you tough. What specifically has been giving you guys trouble?
Well, they've had some chances to work on some stuff. They're throwing a couple new things at us. That's all. It's not that big a deal. We got to execute a little bit better. You know, we got to win on our third downs. We haven't done that yet.
Thanks a lot.
All right.
All right, Lisa. Well, right now, we send it to New York in the Saunders game. Here's John, Craig James, and Doug Flutie. Take it away, Big John. Yes, indeed. USC wants a shot at the title, but they have not yet pulled away from their arch rival UCLA. 9-7 as we get ready to start the third quarter. USC sits number 2 to Ohio State in the BCS standings. Almost all the experts believe a win would be enough. Don't need style points. However, Michigan and Florida are right there. So let's take a look at the top 25 opponents. Arkansas, Notre Dame, Nebraska, California, all falling to the Trojans. For Michigan, Wisconsin, Notre Dame lost to Ohio State. LSU and Tennessee in the Florida side of the ledger. So those are the current rankings, and SC played a very tough schedule. Now let's talk about UCLA and Patrick Cowan. How difficult is it as a defensive coordinator when you face a running quarterback like that?
I think it's the hardest thing because you can't account for the quarterback on every play. I mean, you say, let's spy on him, but it's hard to spy on him when it's 1st and 10 and they come out of there with play action. The bottom line, if you're USC, one time, make him pay for it, and you'll slow him down a little bit. But, I mean, Patrick Cowan, to me, the story of the first half, half of UCLA's offense with him running the football.
USC won the toss, deferred, so they'll handle the ball here to start the second half. Their running back, C.J. Gable, lets it go out of the end zone. It'll come out on the 20. Now the best buy playbook, and we'll take a look at exactly what Coach was telling you.
And Brent, on passing downs, you have to be very careful of USC. Don't play man-to-man coverage, but it's hard to account for a guy that can scramble every play.
And then when John David Booty rallied the Trojans, he was a little more efficient. So with John David Booty out here, Coach, what can he do against this speed upfield rush?
I think it's really important for John David Booty. Those defensive ends from UCLA are going to get up the field. He's going to have to step up in the pocket. But Brent, look to throw the ball down the field, something Troy Smith does a tremendous job of. He's not going to be able to just set his feet, but look to throw off the scramble.
Here's Chauncey. So Washington with the first carry, and Chris Horton takes him down. And our Pacific Life game summary shows you the first half numbers over there. Rushing for UCLA, 50 of those rushing yards, Coach, belong to the quarterback.
And you have to give Cowan a lot of credit. You have to go back to Carl Durrell's decision to start Cowan over Ben Olsen. A great decision.
Second down and 10 for John David. Going to keep it in the air. Incomplete. Wanted Davis, the tight end. Now, we have talked about John David Booty and Matt Leinart, and here are some comparison numbers from a year ago to this year, Coach.
And they actually say John David Booty a little bit stronger arm than Matt Leinart, but we've been impressed all year with the development of John David Booty. But what a big third down right here.
It's hard to stay up at the top week after week after week, and here against a rival determined to end a seven-game losing streak, UCLA is playing a whale of a game, and the Trojans are not sharp. Third down and 15, quick, and it is punting time coming up for USC, and the Bruins are very much in the thick of this now. They got a chance now, Coach, to go all the way, not just stay close.
And I am so impressed. You're right, Brent. I am so impressed with Dwayne Walker, the defensive coordinator. That time came with a zone blitz, spied the nose guard, Chase Moline, out of there, kind of anticipating that little hot route by USC.
Wojnarowski. At the 20-yard line, it's fielded by Graves. Look at Alley. Got it. Stumbles down at the 45. Ryan Graves, the sophomore from California, a 24-yard return after a 39-yard punt. And look at what we've got here, ladies and gentlemen.
And USC, 84th in the country, Brent, in net punting. They've given up two punt returns for touchdowns this year, and he was within a whisker of breaking that one.
Split backs, they've thrown from this formation. They're going to again. Spins away. Cowan on the move. A strike. Marcus Everett, who brought the play in from the sideline, makes the reception, and it's a first and 10, 14 yards.
And you have to love Patrick Cowan, that has had so much success running the football, Brent. This time he scrambles, but he looks to throw the ball down the field instead of just taking off and running for a huge first down right there. Again, Marcus Everett on the catch.
Everett set down beautifully. First down and 10. Ball across the 15-yard line. Cowan keeps it on the ground with Martin. Now our quarterback comparison today, and in one area where John David cannot hold up, is running the football. 50-7. Cowan with an edge. And in passing the ball, 196-85, John David.
And you love right there. Zero interceptions by the young Cowan.
Second down and 8 now. Cowan fires end zone. Incomplete. What'd you think of the yellow?
I thought there was going to be some yellow come out. Kerry Harris hanging with Junior Taylor right there. Had what they wanted, the out route. Good no call right there.
Looked a little bit like Harris slipped at the end, too, didn't it?
I've got to ask you one thing. Sure. I bet our ratings in the states of Ohio and Michigan are off the charts right now. You know Troy Smith, Jim Trust, the whole state of Ohio is watching this, and you know they're watching in Michigan now.
How about state of Florida?
Well, yeah, but they got the SEC championship game.
They
got
to take care of their business.
Exactly.
Right? Third down and eight. Quick pop over the middle. Can they get the first down? Do not. Now it's a decision. Everett was the receiver. He's got the best field goal kicker. But does he want to settle for the one-point lead here? Wheels are turning. Wants the spot. Will he go?
He's going to kick it if it's short.
Crowd yelling to go. He's got a good running quarterback. And he wants a field goal team. Yeah, somehow with a left hand, you could see him. And so here it comes. He's the all Pac-10 field goal kicker. He'll be named to a couple of All-American teams next week. He's a senior, Justin Medlock. 24 of 28 this year, and he's hit all 25 of his extra points. This would boost the Bruins ahead, and coach, you're saying, good move.
Oh, I agree. I mean, make it a 10-9 game. Let your defense go play. Points are hard to come by against USC's defense now.
Here's your 22-yard. It's for the lead. Let's see the reaction. So UCLA leading USC 10-9. ESPN's College Football on ABC returns after this message and a word from our ABC stations. All right, it's time to wheel the victory bell back to its hiding place, its vault here at USC. But should the Bruins hang on, it must be turned over Monday and painted blue. On fourth down, quick snap, they ate it up. Bruin football. Durrell's defense holds the most emotion we've seen him show in maybe years. Minus four on the play. Christian Taylor, the linebacker, makes the stop.
Interesting call out of respect for the UCLA defense. They get up and snap it quick. And I mean, Christian Taylor just runs through unblocked, Brent. Sometimes when you go on that quick count, you don't have a chance to see what the defensive line's in. What a huge stop. Carl showing some juice right now.
Got that first down and 10 for Patrick Cowan. He'll show a whole lot more if they can hang on here for the final 15 minutes. Marquee across the 45-yard line. It was Tommy Prothero once. He described his UCLA team as those gutty little Bruins. And here they are, the gutty little Bruins, 15 minutes away. That would be one of the biggest upsets in the history of this series. All the money's on the table for USC. Second down. Closing is never easy. McKee. Penalty flag comes flying to the umpire. Usually that's holding.
Holding. On the offense, number 71. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Repeat second down.
Tabaga that time. Remember, the inability to hold him out led to that safety in the first half.
Hurt early in the year. Pete Carroll glad to have him back. And UCLA, can they execute good enough to close the deal? Last series, fumbled snap, lateral that was the turnover. Now the holding penalty, Brent. The offense has to execute.
Second down and 15. The Bruins must get to midfield for a first down. Need 15 here on the second down. Cowan rolls the pocket hard, throws back low, incomplete, and here's the third down and 15.
Look at Patrick Cowan. He's smiling a little bit there. He hadn't been a quarterback long enough to feel the heat. He's kind of naive. Only started his senior year in high school. Only recruited by Sacramento State and Idaho.
Third down. Gets time. Fires high. Grab. First down. Everett. Marcus Evert snares another one.
And USC only rushes three. Patrick Cowan has time to step up, and another great route and a great catch by Marcus Evert. But look at the time. Marcus Evert has stepped up today, Brent, and made some catches. These UCLA wide receivers under fire earlier in the season for no playmakers. They're making some plays today.
So on third and 15, they pick up 21. Come back, middle, open marquee, bust for 12 more, and that's another first down.
UCLA, a zone blocking team. Jim Coletto, the offensive line coach. Momentum of the game so big right now. UCLA riding that momentum and running the football.
Jim Coletto, a very good football coach. Was once the head coach at Purdue. Was once a coordinator for Bob Davy at Notre Dame. He's been in the National Football League with Baltimore and Oakland. He has a hand in what's going on here. The backup now, Williams. Makes a stop on Derek Williams, the junior.
You read the body language right now of these USC players, and read the body language right now of Patrick Cowan. Momentum completely on the side right now of UCLA.
Here it is, second down and 8 for UCLA, leading the number 2 ranked team, USC, by a point. 11 minutes now to go in regulation. Play fake. Cowan rolling hard to the left. Wants to run it. Cuts back. Got his first down. And I believe a penalty flag. The side judge over there. At least I saw something. There's another one coming down.
I think, Brent, they're going to get Dallas Sartz over there on a late hit out of bounds on Patrick Cowan.
After the play, personal foul on the defense, late hit on the 42. So it's half of this to the goal. First down.
Let's take a look now, see what happened. Number 42 is the linebacker in question. Not sure about that one, Coach. It looked to me like he was right on the edge there, and that.
You know, Brent, I agree, because that kid can run, Patrick Cowan. Is Sark supposed to not know he's going to could cut back against the grain and stay in bounds? Let him play.
We'll see if the Bruins can take advantage. Moline in as a running back. He probes the middle, and the Trojans are there. They push the pile a little bit. Going behind the left side, which is Lonis. Alexei Lonis grew up in Russia. Over here, he's a freshman, Los Angeles, California. Earned his football after coming over to the United States, number 78. Tavaga, a junior over there.
You know, UCLA with the open date last week. USC playing that late game in the Coliseum against Notre Dame. UCLA looks a little fresher, maybe because they have so much momentum going right now.
Play fake, Cowan. In trouble, took a sack. Wow. At the 12-yard line. A lot of coaches will tell you, instead of that, Bob, throw that thing out of the back of the end zone down there in the red zone.
Well, Brent, that was a big sack. They come with Cushing, the outside linebacker. And also Sartz. But you're right. I mean, that would have been a good opportunity to throw it away.
Here's a third down and goal, and it's back at the 12-yard line.
One good thing, that clock just keeps ticking.
Oh, this holding into a field goal would be huge for the Trojans right here. This is a major third down in this game. Slips, comes back, drops it off to the tight end. That won't get him a touchdown.
Oh, man.
Starts helping finish up against Paulson. Harris also there. Rivers. So here comes the field goal unit. Here comes Justin Medlock. After making one earlier, he's 25 of 29 for the season. One of the best kickers in the country.
Brent, you are right. Just holding them to a field goal opportunity, huge. as UCLA had that ball inside the five and couldn't capitalize.
Cowan's the holder. Yarder is good. 8:49 left. Can USC make it to Arizona? Patrick Cowan and the Bruins with a courageous performance here so far against a USC team that came to the Rose Bowl favored by two touchdowns. Everybody's choice to wind up in Arizona to play Ohio State. But hold on, everybody. Here comes the kickoff by Medlock. It'll be down in the end zone. Now let's take a look at the ESPNU All-State standings review. I know some of you have just joined us. And of course, there are the Buckeyes. They are in. USC looked to be in good shape until they met UCLA. So Michigan, which is idle and lost only by 3 points in Columbus, they've got a heck of an argument. And now Florida trying to put some numbers against Arkansas. So let the computers work. First down and 10. Pump fake, closing in, sacked. At the 25-yard line, Bruce Davis, who has been spectacular. 6'3", 237 pounds from Houston, Texas.
And Brent, again, Sam Baker, an NFL offensive tackle, a little bit late getting out of his stance. And that time, Bruce Davis kind of powered him back into the quarterback.
Second down and 14. Backfield is empty. UCLA rushes four. Incomplete. Here's what the Trojans haven't been able to do here. Four punts on downs. Haven't gained even 35 yards on a single drive against this defense. Spectacular with Dwayne Walker, the defensive coordinator. Came to the Bruins from the NFL. Has had an extra week to read what John David Booty, there he is, on that far side. And he is the assistant coach of the day right now. No question about it.
And just watch the matchup between Sam Baker, Kyle Williams, the two offensive tackles, and these two defensive ends from UCLA.
Bruins rush four. John David fires Smith, got it short of the first down, but you would think he's going to have to go. Christian Taylor unloads on him at 4:30 here. You go back to the last time that USC played in the Rose Bowl against Texas, and you come down to that fourth down that they failed to pick up, but they didn't hesitate. There's 4.5 minutes left here for Pete Carroll.
And Brent, he's going to go for it right here. Even though they have three timeouts left, I think Pete Carroll will go for it on fourth down. I do think they're a little short. Most coaches with three timeouts, the kind of defense USC has, UCLA's been unable to move the football, would punt the football right here knowing you're going to get it back. But Pete Carroll has lived with this, and it's the biggest reason he's been successful. He rolls the dice.
Trying to make it the hard way here. John David's got the play. He's coming out now.
You have to think quarterback sneak.
Remember they ran that little fake against Notre Dame last week and pitched out to a running back going wide.
And did it once already today. I think they're going to sneak it, Brent.
Tight formation. Bruins close in. Quick snap. Booty keeps trying to move the pile. It looks like he passed that yellow line for a first down.
And I'll tell you, I give Pete Carroll credit because he is consistent with it. Went for it on fourth down in the Rose Bowl. Didn't make it. He didn't shy away.
Now look at this reaction. Where is the spot?
Boy, I thought he made it just looking at the surge. Where's the football?
Well,
he's got the foot down.
The scrum down at the bottom, but the plays were whistled down. Now, where the spot is versus that yellow line, which is not always 100%, but it's been a pretty good measurement. So we'll let them bring it out, and they'll show us. There we go.
Oh, yeah.
Length of a football.
Thought they at least have a bit of a Reggie Bush push in there. He did it on his own right there. USC still with three timeouts.
That chain measurement helps that UCLA defense get their breath. First down and 10. They curl, they rush 5, and it's incomplete. Working games with the outside linebacker and the defensive end. And they have caused USC problems here today. 13-9 and 3:59. Second down and 10.
Dwayne Jarrett has to show up here, doesn't he, Brent? It has to be Dwayne Jarrett time.
Coming in underneath the gable, short of the first down.
And that time, UCLA, Dwayne Walker, double teamed. They bracket coverage. Dwayne Jarrett forced Booty to go to the check down.
USC with all three of its timeouts remaining, in case you're wondering. UCLA with 2. Need 3. Fires for it. Got it. Tight end Davis crosses midfield. Chains move. And clock ticks as soon as they restart it.
Again, I'm impressed with Dwayne Walker, Brent. He flat double teamed Dwayne Jarrett again. So they're trying to take the big playmaker out of the game, force USC to go somewhere else.
Jarrett on the game, 4 catches for 68 yards. Davis, the tight end, 6 for 68. Comes to Smith underneath. And he's drilled by Rodney Vann, number 3, at the end. Troy Brown was also there.
A lot of people thought UCLA got really conservative defensively at the end of the Notre Dame game. Getting a little bit conservative right here, Brent. I look for him to heat him up. I mean, Dwayne Walker learned earlier. He did the same thing against Cal. They got conservative. I don't think they're going to sit back much longer. They're going to come after Booty.
They'll try to run forward. Gable, and he'll be thrown down short of it. On second down, Justin Hickman, number 17 at the bottom of the pile. He's the senior from Glendale, Arizona, and that is where USC is trying to get.
Brent, that was a great play by Hickman. Watch 17 on the inside move. Beats the guard, 66, Rachel. Great move. Love the tight end, Fred Davis. Third down yardage right here.
The freshman's his running back, Gable. Bruins rush 4. Booty steps up, fires complete at the 25-yard line to Smith. Steve Smith, the senior.
And they went after the freshman, true freshman, Alteron Burner, number 1. Again, they're bracketing Dwayne Jarrett, which means it's one-on-one coverage. And John David Booty, you see him going through the whole progression right there and found the one-on-one coverage.
Pump fake, comes back. Complete now to McFoy. So here, Rose Bowl in Pasadena, California. UCLA upsetting USC 13-9. A minute and a half to play in regulation with Bob Davey and Lisa Salters. I'm Brett Musburger. Nice to have all of you along with us who've been here all day, and those of you who are just joining us. This has been, no matter what happens, a tremendous performance by the Bruins. Booty fires end zone, incomplete. His man was covered. He came back to Chris McFoy. And they are going to move to third down. The last time the Trojans played the Rose Bowl, not a happy ending. But there was ecstasy in the state of Texas when Vince Young and the Horns pulled it out in the closing seconds. Now it is third down and four here. USC only 6 of 16 on third downs today. Deflected, intercepted on the deflection. What a play by Eric McNeil, the senior backup linebacker from Carson, California. The deflection and the pick. And joy reigns in Michigan and Florida.
And the UCLA defense, Brent, they didn't seal the deal in South Bend, but they're able to seal it right here. Eric McNeil, a converted safety who is now the nickel linebacker, they will remember that play forever.
Three timeouts remaining, and USC has just used one of them. So USC's first turnover of the game may have cost them a spot in the national championship game. 13-9. And UCLA 1-10 away from one of the biggest upsets in the history of this rivalry. Can you imagine not just snapping a losing streak, not just beating your arch rival, but keeping them from playing for a national championship? It don't get any bigger than that. No way, no how. Carl Durrell, by far the biggest win of his coaching career. If they can just hang on here for 1-10. Tried to punch the ball out. That's Kevin Ellison. It looked like he was punching the running back, but he was trying to punch the ball out, and folks who didn't have a good angle on that they're really upset about that. So there's another timeout.
USC number two.
One left, and now Pete wants to make sure that he calms them down. 102. USC wanted to force the punt, give themselves at least 16. Takeaway would be their first preference. Second down and 12. Keep the clock running. Marquis. Down at the 22-yard line. This will be third down.
And Brent, I've got it to where this is USC's last timeout. So it could be fourth down with about 20 seconds, maybe 16 seconds left on fourth down for UCLA if nothing bizarre happens right here. So they're going to force UCLA into a fourth down decision with around 20 seconds left in this game. And Brent, can I get Dwayne Walker a pay raise right now, the defensive coordinator for UCLA?
Brilliant job.
If they took a vote of all these people wearing blue, he'd be the highest paid defensive coach in the country after this game.
Here is third down and 8 for Cowan and the Bruins. Here's the running play, and now the punt. Ball is spotted inside the 25-yard line.
USC has blocked 4 kicks on the season. Why this clock is stopped right now.
It's strange that he stopped the clock right there. Of course, that's coming up next at Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship of Kansas City, Nebraska, Oklahoma. That'll be a great scene. But here we've come down to 39 ticks of the clock left. And here comes Perez now and the punt team.
Brett, they're going to let it run down.
Taking the seconds.
UCLA has not had any punt blocked all season. I think it's too far out to mess with taking a safety or anything like that. Just catch it, punt it, the ball game.
And you got Desmond Reed back here. That speed is a return man. They bring it down to 13 seconds.
Again, UCLA has not had a punt blocked. Just punt it away from Desmond
Timeout,
Reed.
Timeout, UCLA. The timeout was called prior to the expiration of the play clock.
And this is unbelievable right now. I don't think anyone in the country saw this coming. And how about the BCS decision now, Brent, of potentially Michigan or Florida going to Glendale?
Reed is back as a return man. Reed's long, 43 yards. Gets it off. Reed being driven way back. It's a boomer on the hop. Away from it with four ticks of the clock left. 4 seconds away after a 62-yard punt by Perez. Bruins were drawn back into the prevent, and a national championship is about to disappear. Any chance has eluded USC unless they stage a miracle. Deep to Smith. Ricochet, the gutty little Bruins have done it. They have stunned USC. Let's go to Lisa.
Coach Durrell, I asked Pete Carroll the same question. Obviously, it's going to be different for you. What are you feeling right now?
I feel great for our players. You know, they had to endure a whole lot of information, a lot of mess. It was just fun for them. I really am proud of them. They hung in there. Nobody believed in us. We only believed in ourselves. And this is just great for them. So I'm just really happy for them.
When you saw that deflection and interception, what went through your mind?
We got a chance to win it. And that's all we wanted to do is stay close, stay in the game, play great defense, be smart with the ball on offense, get some points on the board and get a chance to win. And that's what we did.
Now, other than you guys, who believed that you guys could pull off this upset?
Nobody. Nobody. That's why I love these guys. Great kids, great character. Had a four-game losing streak. They hung in there together. We went 3-0 at the end of the season, which was important for us to do, and we did that today.
Describe the performance of your quarterback, the guy you decided to go with, the guy you went with the last six games, Patrick Cowan.
courageous. Courageous. Big time game, big time atmosphere. He made some plays with his feet, made some great throws. Guys stepped up and made some plays. We need it. We needed that kind of effort.
How long are you going to celebrate this one?
I tell you what, I haven't won this game since I've been here. I'm going to celebrate this one a long time, so thanks.
Thanks a lot. Congratulations.
So congratulations to Carl Durrell. The upset of the year. And an update, Florida 17, Arkansas 7. Let the computers whir. And folks, I know it's a cliche, but that's why they play these games. You know, Bobby, it was wonderful to sit in here, and you're so happy for UCLA. But on the other hand, sadness for Pete Carroll and the Trojans. They gave themselves an opportunity, but they really didn't play well.
That's it. As a former coach, I compare those emotions of Carl Durrell, what he's feeling right now, what those Bruins are feeling in the locker room, compared to what Pete Carroll is feeling in that USC team. But don't ever underestimate, it's a lot easier to be the spoiler. But UCLA came in here. They earned this win today.
What a night it'll be for them. Once again, 13-9. UCLA stuns USC. So for Lisa Salters and Bob Davey, I'm Brett Musburger. We certainly hope you enjoyed being with us this afternoon from the Rose Bowl. So long, everybody.